Hi everyone, welcome to Let's Learn. This is Automations Part 2. If you haven't seen Part 1, you can always dive into that, but if you're ready to start to explore more advanced features within automations, you're in the right place. Let's talk a little bit about what Let's Learn is. Let's Learn is a series of videos where you can learn a specific topic in 15 minutes or less. So what we're trying to do is walk you through not only the strategy and why you should want to use something, but the technical application of it within our test account as well. So today we're going to talk about Automations Part 2. We'll cover our example business, how you can use different recipes and ones that you should look at. We'll talk through the customer journey and using automations to create really tailored customer experiences. We'll talk through creating goals and how you can use those to effectively take contacts to certain pathways in your automations. We'll demo all of these things, and then we'll close with some next steps. Before we start, we want to make sure that you hit that subscribe button on our YouTube channel and take an opportunity to subscribe so that you know every single time we put out an educational video just like this. Let's talk about our example business. Our business is Boone's Bandanas. This is an e-commerce business that sells all different products for dogs. So we're selling, you know, bandanas, harnesses, leashes, collars, but we're also a nonprofit. We donate to animal shelters. You buy a bandana, we donate a bandana. Every month we highlight a specific animal shelter in our area, and we take an opportunity to hold adoption events with all of those donated bandanas. We're using a lot of functionality within ActiveCampaign. So not only the main features, but we've really taken an opportunity to dive into those more accessible and advanced features. And we integrate with Shopify. So there's a lot of cool things that you can do if you're an e-commerce store, or depending on whatever kind of business you have, that can allow you to create different integrations that work for you. Now let's dive into our topic for today. In our previous session, we talked about how you can create an automation strategy, and we gave you an opportunity to really start to dive into how you can build your automations. So what we want to do today now is move on to the things that we haven't talked about already. What you can do, like I said, is start to use recipes more strategically. Using recipes strategically will give you an opportunity to take the processes that you want to automate and use our recipes to do that exactly for you. We have over 600 recipes in our library, so you should have an opportunity to use any of those at any given time as they work for your customer's journey. And speaking of your customer journey, you really want to think of how you can implement that into your automation practices. So what are going to be the best strategies for meeting your contacts where they're at in the journey with your business? Building goals is going to be a really good way to do that, because based on certain actions that contacts are taking, you're going to be able to bring people down to certain spots in automations. So let's explore this a little deeper. First, what are some main recipes that you want to explore? I would encourage you to use the first two, no matter what, regardless of what type of business you are. Engagement tagging is going to be a recipe that you can utilize to apply tags to your contacts based on their certain levels of engagements. So instead of you having to guess if they're engaged or try to understand what their last engage date was, you can use this engagement tagging part one and part two recipe in order to take an opportunity to just further understand really easily how your contacts are engaging with you. Welcome series are going to be the best way to welcome your contacts to your business. Give them a little bit more info on who you are, what your values are, what are the things that they can be expecting from you. Maybe they're, you know, a nonprofit and you send them a different kind of message than you would somebody who's making a purchase from your e-commerce store. Applying the customer journey to your welcome series will really, really help you, and we have some good recipes for that. Last is your abandoned cart. Now, I would say definitely utilize this if you are an e-commerce business, because you're going to be able to set this recipe up, and every time somebody abandons a cart, an automation will trigger based on that and drive somebody to make that conversion or to make that purchase. I will show you where all of these recipes live here in just a second. Let's talk a little bit about applying your customer journey. How can you use the customer journey alongside automations? One way that I think about is taking it into consideration the actions and the places that your contacts are at within your business. Are you site tracking them? Have they submitted a form? Are they on the cusp of conversion? If they are, once you start to understand that, you can create automations around these direct stages. Meeting your contacts where they're at will not only help you to create really great customer experiences, but it'll also help you to really have an organized, seamless business strategy. So starting to understand what happens in your awareness stage, what happens in your consideration stage. When somebody makes that decision or that conversion to make a purchase, what are the things that you want them to do? How are you growing your contacts? And how are you turning them into advocates? So people that are writing reviews, making additional purchases, really taking an opportunity to share you on social media and become those true VIP customers. This journey is never ending because you want to continue that relationship post-sale so that you have people who are really, really, you know, number one fans of your business. Now, let's talk about goals and what they are. Goals are ways for you to move contacts to one spot in an automation to another spot, letting them bypass certain steps that you've created. They sort of act as an anchor. So they're saying, hey, Tabitha did this action, so we're gonna bypass her over two emails and two wait periods into this next step that we want her to take. It's not necessarily a conversion. Maybe it can be something around a registration date, or they've gotten a tag, or they've submitted the form that you're looking for them to submit, or they clicked on a link in one of your campaigns. Goals can make sure that you're really creating nice, seamless customer experiences or contact experiences based on you moving them around from step to step. Because what you're doing is really allowing your contacts to move based on the ways that they're interacting with your business. Let's go ahead. We're going to dive into the platform, and I really want to take an opportunity to show you all of these awesome things we just talked about. Now that we're in the platform, we've toggled specifically to automations. We can see that we have all of our automations here perfectly assigned with their labels. What we want to do is we want to toggle to our label of engagement so that we can focus on the engagement tagging automations. We have part one and part two right here. If you're wondering where those live, they live under create an automation, and they're the second and third automation recipes that you'll see right when you open that page. So we're going to click on part one, as you'd want to set that up first. Part one is going to give you an opportunity to push your contacts through based on the engagements that they're going through. So are they engaging? Are they becoming unengaged? Whatever it might be. You can see here that we're adding two tags as soon as they enter into this automation. And then we're removing two tags. We're waiting 7 days. If they don't do anything, we're removing this recent activity tag. We're waiting 7 more days, and we're adding disengaged and removing engaged. This will make a little bit more sense when we look at part two and tie together exactly what's happening. So you can see what's happening is over the course of about 28 days, the contact is receiving tags or removing tags based on the actions or lack of actions that they're taking. Now, if we were to go back and click on part two is going to serve as the part of our automations that actually offers and holds our start triggers. So we'll go right back and we'll click on part two. The reason we don't need start triggers in part one is because part two is sort of the engine that operates these actual automations. So here are our three start triggers. You can create whatever start triggers make the most sense for you. Reads an email, clicks on a link, and visits our webpage. If they do any of these three things and they live anywhere in any wait period of part one, we're going to remove them from that automation, because what we want to do is remove them and put them in at the top. So this is where the engine is working best. It's saying, hey, does Tabitha live anywhere in part one? And if she does, let's take her out and make sure that she lands right back at the top because she recently engaged and now she needs to receive those two tags, recently active and engaged. We want to make sure that we're focusing on operating based on the start triggers and levels of engagement that matter to us. If we go back to automations and we want to explore our welcome series, we can do that together. In order to find it without labels, we're going to click here and hit search, and we're going to search for our welcome series. Here's our community welcome automation, but we want to use the welcome series that come from the recipes. So we'll click on welcome series Boone's List. Now you can tweak any kind of recipes that you're using along the way, but just know you have all of these different kinds of recipes in order to operate functionally for you. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna hit back because we don't want this start trigger to exist anymore. So you can see here, they subscribe to our monthly newsletter. They get a thanks for signing up. They go through different wait periods and we're truly just welcoming them to our automation. Again, we have a lot of information to fill in here through the automation wizard, but it's really important to note that we've tweaked this based on the things that make sense for Boone's Bandanas. Your welcome series can look any type of way for the different things that you're doing and how you're welcoming your contacts to ActiveCampaign. If you want to start with our welcome series recipe, go ahead, click on Create an Automation. And as you do that, you can search welcome series just like we did right here, and our welcome series will come up. You can click on this, follow the wizard through the setup, and then tweak it to match your business specifically. Now, there's a couple other things that we want to look at. Meeting your customers where you're at through your customer journey is going to be crucial in your business, as we discussed when we looked at the customer journey graphic. So we're going to click on this community welcome automation. And what I want to do here is walk through how and why you would set up certain goals. So in this automation, we're looking to do a couple things. Somebody submits our form that they are interested in the community. Based on that, we're sending them three different emails. And in these three different emails, our goal is to try and get them to join the Facebook group. You can see here that we have an if-else statement that says, did they do that? Did they join the Facebook group? But what it's important to note is, if at any time through these three emails, they do that goal, they join that Facebook group, they don't need to continue on this path. They don't need to continue receiving these emails. They've done exactly what we were looking for them to do. So we're using that customer journey to say, hey, once somebody joins a Facebook group, let's put them into the next step of their journey. And the perfect thing for you to use to really bypass those steps in the event that they join the Facebook group is goals. So let's set one up together. We're going to click here under our wait period and we're going to use the plus sign and we're going to go to conditions and workflow and click our yellow goal step. Our goal step is going to say joined Facebook group. And this is saying, what action are you looking for the contact to achieve? What defines this goal? We're going to click here, add a goal, and we're going to say tag exists joined Facebook group. So now, what this goal is looking for is somebody receiving this tag. Now, a couple other things that I want to explain. We want to say below this contact's position, or you can say anywhere. If you're looking to pull somebody from a different path in an automation to another path, let's say a yes path to a no path, then you would use anywhere. But since they're just coming from a very, very linear automation, we can use below contact's position. We're not looking to trigger any conversion. And if the contact does not meet the goal, we still want them to continue in the automation. So you can wait until specific conditions are met, so hold them in the goal until they do the action, or you can simply end the automation if they're not achieving the goal. We're going to say continue anyways, like I said, because we want them to do certain things. So now what can happen is Tabitha comes into the Boons community. On the second email, she clicks on the link in your email that allows you to join the Facebook group. So she no longer needs to wait here in this wait period. She doesn't need this third email, and she certainly does not need to wait here for 7 days. So we're going to take her from this step and drag her all the way down to the goal, letting her achieve the goal, and then continue into the automation as needed. If they never ever click on the link to join the Facebook group, they'll bypass the goal, not achieving it, get to the if-else statement, and go down the no path as intended. Now, let's go ahead. We'll talk about some next steps and the things that we want you to do now that you've finished this automations part two. First of all, sign up for our office hours. It's a great opportunity for you to get your questions answered from a live education team member, specifically my team member, Shiv. He's really great at answering your questions and bringing you on stage if you want to demo something together. Also, join our community. Our community is a great place for you not only to see live videos, but to also get more information from customers just like yourself. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit that bell so that you can get notifications every time a Let's Learn video just like this comes up. If you're looking to learn more about goals or the things that we covered today, feel free to explore more of our Let's Learn series on our YouTube channel and go directly to our Let's Learn goals. We'll dive a little bit deeper into that, and we hope to see you next time as you start to build automations that make the most sense for you. Happy automating, and can't wait to see what you build.